Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me, and I'm going to show you something in this video on how you can speed up your WordPress website. Now, it's going to be a little technical, like the concept, but implementing it is going to be so easy. It's just a few mouse clicks. Now, the technical side of it is what powers your WordPress-based website is it's on a web hosting account, and there's certain services on that web hosting account to make it work. You have something called a MySQL for the database, is where all your data is stored. Then you have Apache or something like that that's being acting as your web server. There's a couple other options there. Apache is very common. And there's also something called PHP. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to change the PHP version to a current version, and when you do this, your website's going to be faster. It's going to be a lot snappier when you're in the back end of the website or the front end of the website. Now, this is actually a big deal. There is one of the goals of WordPress, the WordPress.org, the body that is controlling WordPress, is they want everyone using PHP 7. They want every theme on PHP 7, every plugin on PHP 7, and I'm going to show you how to upgrade. Now, if you go and get a new web hosting account, chances are they're not going to put PHP 7 on your web hosting account, but most are going to give you the option to choose which PHP version that you're on. So you might be on version 5.5 or 5.6. I don't know what happened to PHP 6, but anyways, we're on PHP 7 and we're deep into it. Now, the reason why these web hosts aren't putting you on PHP 7 is because not everything is compatible with it. And that is where it can get a little dicey. So for them to put you on the lower version makes sense because it's going to reduce support requests and things like that. Now, any modern developed plugin or theme, it's going to already be compatible most likely with PHP version 7. Now, if you're using some offshoot old plugin from some scammy internet marketer that was coded in 2014, there's a good chance that PHP 7 is not going to work for you because you're not using plugins and themes developed by reliable developers that are actually still in business. So I'm going to show you how to first test your WordPress-based website to see if the code on it will work with PHP 7. There's a tool. And then I'm going to show you how to go into your web hosting account and change the PHP version. So there's this plugin we're going to use, and it's actually made by WP Engine. They're one of the more premium web hosts. Hosting, the cheapest hosting plan with them is $30 per month, and I think that's when you pay annually. So they're not the cheapest web host, but they came out with this plugin called PHP Compatibility Checker. Now here's the thing, when I looked at this, I first looked at the reviews here. And there's a couple one-star reviews, and when I read them, some developers of plugins and themes were saying it wasn't detecting that their software was compatible when it is. So that is one of the caveats, but let's just go through it together. So I'm in the back end of a WordPress site here, so I'm going to go to Plugins, Add New. Now, I've never used this. I recently updated to PHP 7 my site, and I'm the run and gun type of guy. I'm just going to do it and deal with the consequences later. That's not necessarily a good practice, but that's what I do more times than not. But what's nice is when we change it to 7, we can easily change it back to a lower version if something doesn't work right. So I'm going to go ahead and click on install now. And let's run it for the first time and see. Hopefully it's instantaneous and it works pretty quick. So let's see, I'm assuming it's going to be under tools. There it is, tools, PHP compatibility. And we're going to test it for version 7. And let's only scan for what's active. I'm pretty sure I don't really have anything active. So it's just scanned the 2016 theme. Of course it is. Let me scan all plugins and themes because I have some other stuff in there. And let's see what it says. Now, some people were complaining that there was false positives, but then there was a newer version of this plugin that came out maybe 2 months ago, and it was supposed to deal with a lot of those problems. Okay, now while it's running, not sure how long it's going to take because I've never used this before, I'm going to show you how to change your PHP version in your web hosting account. Actually, it looks like it's almost done. So I'm using InMotion Hosting, and but this will work with any web host. Now, every web host is a little different. There's going to be some web hosts that don't want to give you the ability to change this. I don't know why, but there are hosts like that. In that case, you're going to have to submit a support ticket saying, hey, I want to go on PHP version 7. But InMotion Hosting does give you the ability. And I have a promotion with InMotion. They give all my viewers a 56% discount. I'll also throw a link in down below to that. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and click on cPanel. Now, cPanel is that standard control panel that most web hosts are using. And then I'm going to scroll down to where it says PHP Configuration. It's right here. And I'm going to click on that, and it's showing all the versions that are available to me and the version that I'm using right now. So I can put version 7, and this is RC right here. That just means it's a release candidate. I would not recommend that. So I would use this 7 right here. So I'm going to go to version 7.0 instead of 7.1. Let's go back and take a look at that plugin to see if it's done. It's still scanning, but it's okay. I'm going to implement it anyway. So anyways, you do that, and then you just click on update, and literally now you are on the higher version of PHP, and what's going to happen is your WordPress-based website's going to be a lot snappier. I've noticed my site is a lot snappier. In fact, WordPress is going to require web hosts to give you PHP 7 by default if they want to be listed on WordPress.org. So anyways, I don't know if this is going to finish by the end of this video, but I do know that it's probably taking so long because I have a bunch of themes on there. I should have maybe cleared out those themes, but you get the point. You can run your test. Now, here's the best part about it is because you're using cPanel and it's not some server of your own, you can easily come back here if something didn't work right, and you can just go down a version. Now, some of the caveats are if you're running non-WordPress apps on your hosting account, this upgrades the entire hosting account. So you just need to make sure that everything you have is going to be okay on PHP version 7. Maybe you can do this late on a Friday night when you're going to have your least amount of traffic perhaps, and then test everything, make sure it works, and then you're good to go. But most of the reliable plugins and themes, they're all going to be compatible with version 7 of PHP. It's just those real random offshoot plugins or themes that aren't really being supported or actively developed anymore. So anyways, this is one simple trick that you can do right now to make your WordPress website run faster. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.